This truly is a great day for the Church of Jesus Christ. It's a day to celebrate His goodness. This is a great day to come together in His name. And in a moment, we're going to make a prophetic statement to our city that we are the church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here we are, Lord. We have come to do Your will. We're going to bless the name of the Lord. We're going to go forth from this place and bless others in Jesus' name. The Bible says in Psalm 34, verse 1, I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In just a moment, we're going to stand and sing together in a moment, and we're so blessed to have 8 different churches from our Church of Greater Lansing family making up today's worship team. Can we give them a great big God bless you today? Hallelujah. And before we enter into the Lord's presence, I'm going to ask Pastor Wendy to bless our time of worship as we come into His presence with thanksgiving and praise. Pastor Wendy, would you bless our time?
Let's pray together. Lord, we're so blessed to be here together in Your name. We're here as believers and followers, disciples of the Lord Jesus, and we're saved by the blood of the Lamb that was spilled, and we have Your Holy Spirit with us today. We're Your body, and we're blessed to gather together in this place. We recognize today that Your body is being formed in the earth, Lord, that You're pleased with this, and we just enter into that. We come together in this place. And Father, even this morning, we would say that we repent, Father God, if that has not been our mind in the past. And we would come into Your heart in this, that You're forming one body, and that is what You see, and so that is what we see. And we praise You for this opportunity to be as one. Today we're here for You, Lord, and for Your purposes. And we set ourselves in agreement to have Your heart as we do this work in Your name today as we go out, Father God. I pray that Your heart would be our heart. We take up Your desires and Your plans, and we even say, let Jesus have His reward today as these things come forth, and as He's glorified, we say we release Your Spirit. We release Your Spirit for healings, for breakthroughs in lives, for salvations, Father God, in all that's done. Let Your Spirit be moving in this place and as we go out from here. We thank You for this. We praise You for this. And God, as we set our hearts to worship, we say we desire Your presence more than anything. We enter into You. We know as we worship that You come in a greater way, and so we welcome You in this place. We welcome Your presence. We seek after You together. And we praise You, God, that You honor Your word, that You will come. And so we say, come, Lord Jesus. Just rise to Your feet as we prepare to worship. We say, come, Lord. We say, be honored and glorified and lifted up, and let Your name be made famous in this place today as we worship. Amen.
Jesus. Let's give this dynamic worship team a hand today. This is Stephanie Butler from Trinity Church. I'm Walter Gibson from Pilgrim Rest Church. And today we would like to take a few minutes and share with you some of the vision behind the Church of Greater Lansing. First of all, we are excited that we are launching our website today. Let's give God a hand of praise for that. You can find us now in cyberspace at churchofgreaterlansing.com. And none of this would have been possible without a very special young man, Mr. Matt Thor. Matt, where are you? Stand up, Matt. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. We want to thank Matt for the countless hours he has put in to make this website a reality. So we want to give him a shout out today. And Matt, we hope that gets you some business, all right? After today's event, we want to encourage you to go to the website and share your story. How the experience has touched you and how you are able to make a difference in someone else's life.
Amen, amen. We're going to talk a little bit today about the vision behind Kavilim and why we do what we do, who we are. One of the questions that we often get is, what churches participate in Kavilim? And what's interesting, you may be interested to know, that over 30 churches partner with us on a consistent basis. But over 100 churches have participated in some way, shape, or form in the last 2 or 3 years. So that may be through our quarterly summits, it may be through our monthly pastor's prayer, or even at one of these events, like Food Drop 2011.
Well, sometimes it's easier to describe what something is by describing what it is not. The Church of Greater Lansing is not a church in the traditional sense. Many of us come from different churches, but today we are all representing the singular, universal body of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're not simply a mission-minded organization, although those things are good. We are not simply here just to fellowship with one another. We're not just a group motivated by doing things, although we do. And it is not about any one church.
The Church of Greater Lansing, however, is a movement. Amen. It is an answer to the call of God for the church to be Christ to our shared communities, to be real, to be relevant, to be responsive in tangible ways. Hearing and speaking those things that he's saying to us, and seeing and doing and joining with him in those things that he shows us to do. It is a movement that is unapologetically about Christ in us and allowing God's love to shine through us in such a way that people's lives are changed, that their hope is restored, that those cities and streets that have been devastated for generations can be renewed. Amen?
It takes more than one individual to restore a city. And we can testify today about God's goodness and mercy when we look all over this auditorium and see countless men, women, boys, and girls who are on the battlefield for the Lord, ready to take back our city. The Church of Greater Lansing was initiated by a challenge to a group of passionate local pastors interested in linking arms and seeking God's face to see our communities transformed by Christ. But it is a movement sustained by God himself, and the hope that as we join together, we can make a significant difference in our shared communities. We are all a part of the Church of Greater Lansing. Collectively, we are the body of Christ to our community. You are his ambassadors and representatives today. God has arranged the parts in the body, every one of them, just as he wants them to be. And we believe he has called you here today for a very specific purpose. So we couldn't do this without you today.
We said it takes a multitude to restore a city. But the restoration of a city is not accomplished by mere mass participation. It requires people who are resolved, committed, tenacious, persevering, courageous, willing, compassionate, and self-sacrificing. As each of us faithfully does our part, the walls of our cities are being restored. And the beautiful thing about it is that we do it because He first loved us. Amen. It is not by might nor by power, but by His Spirit and by the grace of God alone.
Preach, sister. It is Christ in us, the hope of glory. It is you and it is me. The Church of Greater Lansing is a movement of God amidst His church and people of goodwill. It is a call to put love in action. As we seek to serve this day, we will be putting into action the words of that age-old adage, love isn't love until you give it away. Love never fails.
So in a nutshell, if you're sitting there today and you're wondering, what is the Church of Greater Lansing? It is this. It is a response to the love that God has lavished on us through His Son, Jesus Christ. It is the march of the unqualified, the imperfect, the forgiven, the healed, the thankful, and the restored. How can we not give back what we have so freely received? Amen? Amen. 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 So we want to thank you on behalf of the Church of Greater Lansing for joining us here today. And at this time, I'd like to welcome Pastor Marvin Williams, my senior teaching pastor from Trinity.
Listen, Pastor Walter and Stephanie, I think that the Oscars have it all wrong. That you all are so good, you should be presenting the Oscars tomorrow. We give thanks to God for His presence here today. We have a couple of people that we want to give thanks to. And anytime we look in the Bible and we see the word thank you, there is really a theology of thank you. As we look in the Bible, Paul never gives thank you to a particular person. He always gives thanks to God for the grace of those individuals. So that's what we're doing today. We're giving God thanks for the grace that He's given us through these people. First group of people that we want to thank partnering churches. Listen, over 250 volunteers who work behind the scenes to make this event possible from over 24 to 30 different churches, partnering churches who gave financially, who gave their energy and their time and their resources to make this event happen. And so we thank God for you. A second group, we want to thank businesses and organizations who have partnered as well. We believe that people of good faith can serve alongside people of goodwill. We want to especially thank WKR and the Hope High School. Particularly, we want to thank Dr. Scott, the superintendent of Hope Public High Schools. Dr. Scott. Thank you. We want to thank Hope High School for allowing us to use this facility where we're worshiping today.
Also, we want to thank, we really want to thank the Hope High School football team. If you are here, let us see you, Hope High School. We know that you have gone through a very difficult time over these last few months, or these last couple of months. And we want to let you know that your being here today is a great show of solidarity. It's a great show of giving back to the community, and we thank God for you. Lastly, we would like to thank the public school districts and Tony Conley and the radio shows and TCT and television stations and papers who literally helped to get the word out about Food Drop 2011. Are you ready? Are you ready to be the hands and feet of Jesus today? I think we can do a little bit better than that, right? Are you ready to be the hands and feet of Jesus? Would you join me in welcoming our mayor, Mayor Virge Bernero. Ready to work. Anybody ready to work? Yeah. I know you are. I know you believe in miracles, and one is that I'm just about speechless. I just, from the bottom of my heart, want to say thank you once again. When I saw the cars pulling up this morning, and I knew we were going to be at Hope, I knew there was a big, plenty of room here, Dr. Scott. And I thank you so much for opening your arms and your doors to us. The Church of Greater Lansing is bigger than any one individual, bigger than any one church. It shows the power of what we can do together in His name. And this is the day when we all take faith off the shelf and put it in action, as the pastors have said. There's big challenges, you know, in our communities, in the state, and there's a lot of debate about the role of government. But today is the day when we put all that politics aside and we focus on what is our role as Christians, what is our role? And maybe we'll even say beyond today, as Christians, what is our role? The debates can rage on, but those don't necessarily feed anybody. They don't necessarily keep anybody in their homes. We'll let the political process work, but in the meantime, what can we do? What are we called upon as Christians to do? What is our role? I'm ready to go to work. I'm ready to go to work. God bless you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mayor, for those awesome words. My name's Jim Dunn. I'm pastor of Calvary Christian Fellowship in Lansing. And the last few years, it's just been a joy and an honor to be a part of this event and to serve on the committee. And I want to personally say thank you to all of you wonderful people. Because if it weren't for you, we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be able to do this. And once again this year, you've really opened up your hearts. You've opened up, you've given us your time, you've opened up your wallets and your purses, because obviously we couldn't deliver 2,700 boxes of food if we couldn't buy 2,700 boxes of food. Amen. These are tough times. This is a difficult economy that we're in, but you know what? As things get darker, as times get tougher, the light of the world shines even brighter. And Jesus said, you are the light of the world. And today you get to shine your light like never before. You're going to go into people's homes that are expecting you, that are looking forward to you, and you are going to be Jesus Christ to them. I hope you appreciate what an awesome opportunity God has given you today. Amen. Well, I want to say thank you, and I'm here to actually present a check, a kind of a big check, actually, to Dave Carr of the Mid-Michigan Food Bank. Dave and his staff work hard year-round feeding people in this area, and they're the ones who put together this box of food for us, and we just want to say thank you so much, and we're presenting the money that you raised as the Church of Jesus Christ to buy this food. And so I want to introduce my friend Dave Carr from the Mid-Michigan Food Bank. 92,034.51. Praise the Lord for that. Amen.
Now, this is the third year. Last year, out of abundance that the Lord provided, we were able to take the additional money that we didn't spend on the event and stretch that into 50 pantries in our community, and it served about 3 months worth of food. Praise the Lord.
One other announcement is at the end of the rally, all of you that are pastors of churches that participated in giving of this, would you please come forward? We'll meet right up front here. We're going to just have a quick photo opportunity where we'll all gather around Dave and take another picture. But right now, I want you all to get on your feet and let's praise the Lord some more.
You Surely this just can't be what you saw. Let your kingdom come here in my heart, and I will live to carry your compassion, to love a world that's broken, to be your hand and me. And I will live the life that I've been given, to go beyond religion, to see the world be changed by the power.
Eric, you have a seat now.
Everybody said,
and everybody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
That was awful weak. I need you to say it so that they can hear it in Egypt. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I want you to celebrate with your neighbor. Because this is all about love and action. And turn to that person that's next to you and tell them, I love you and there's nothing you can do about it. Man shall not live by bread alone. In a few minutes, we're going to embark upon a journey throughout this entire community. We're not just going to be delivering boxes of food, but in many ways, we're going to be delivering the bread of life. Christ that is in you. Christ that sealed your life. Christ that delivered you from the bondages and ravages of sin. The Christ that turned your life around. Christ that made your darkness light. And the Christ that made whatever was wrong right. And I know some of you sit here, some of you think that you brought yourselves. But for the most of us, we know from whence we have come. It was not our goodness, it was not our behavior, it was not our pedigree, it was not our education, it was not our material acquisition. But we're here because of the grace of God. And even though this is a food drop and a rally, it is also an opportunity for someone who perhaps are sojourning with us this morning that perhaps do not know Christ, and perhaps want to make that change in your life. We're going to make provisions for you. Because long after we have delivered the substance of food, there is an indelible imprint that will be made in the lives of the 2,700 homes that we will journey to. Because when you take the food basket with you, you also take the presence of Christ with you. You leave a residue. You pray a prayer. You speak to that circumstance. You transform 2,700 homes. You leave your footprints not just in snow, but you leave your footprints in the hearts and minds of people. Do I have a witness in here? Satan is somehow mystified that the body of Christ in Lansing is so unified. He's horrified that we are glorifying the name of the Lord. He's terrified that the kingdom is being magnified. He's been nullified because we are edifying. Just about through. Christ said in the 13th chapter of the book of St. John that above all things, I'm going to give you a new commandment that you love one another. Love was not new to Israel. It was not new to the hearers of the word, but the paradigm by which we love is going to be a little different. You loved according to the law, but there's a new sheriff in town. The law came by Moses, but grace and truth by the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want you to love like I love. And there is something to be said. I'm reminded of Mahatma Gandhi when he made a comment that I love your Christ, but not your Christians. But I wish Mr. Gandhi was here today, he'd have to change his story. Because we're not here because we're Presbyterians, or Episcopalians, or Lutherans, or Methodists, or Apostolic, or Baptists, or Evangelical, or Full Gospel. We're here because we're one in Christ Jesus. Not because we're black, not because we're white, but because we're one in Christ Jesus. Shout in a minute. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, we're going to shout in a minute. There were some commandments
promise that he gave us in the Word of God. He said, I want you to love like I love. Not with words, not with outfits, not with the outward appearance, but love must come from the heart. The Greeks had it right when they presented love in three or four prisms, storge, our family love. They had it right, we ought to love our families. They had it right when they said in philia, we ought to have a brotherly love that's created within us. They had it right when they spoke about eros, attractive love. But they did not understand the depths and the magnitude of agape love, which is a transcendent love, which speaks not about attraction, nor about some type of mechanical love that we find in philia, but it speaks about a godly love. Therefore, 1 John 3:16, hereby perceive we the love of God, that he laid down his life. Love is not love until it becomes active. Somewhere, somehow, God is in heaven, peering over the porch of glory, saying, I'm happy about what's going on. There's some dancing going on in heaven. For too long, we have been fragmented. We have been divided by denominationalism. We've been splintered by our parochial designs. But today in Lansing, today in the Tri-County area, we're about to shake up some things. Our mayor had it right. Transformation is not by the edict of politics. Transformation is not by the edict of entrepreneurial plans. It's not by the edict of the wisdom of man. But if we're going to transform our communities, if we're going to drive crime down and education up, if we're going to drive despair down and hope up, it cannot come from our capital. It cannot come from our city hall. It cannot come from the enclaves of our business. It must come from the body of Christ. There is a power in this place. There is a dunamis in this place. There is authority in this place. One can put 1,000 to flight. Don't you know you are armed and extremely dangerous? Do I have any dangerous people in here?
When we first heard about the food drop last year, we just knew we had to be a part of it. It was exactly what we continually talk to the people about, which is looking for opportunities to be the church.
What the city needed to see was the people of God being involved outside of their own church.
Regardless of race, regardless of denomination, regardless of where the churches happen to be in the greater Lansing map.
To show the community that we're living up to the word of God that says, feed my sheep, whether they are Muslim, whether they are agnostic. We're feeding the sheep of God and hoping that they will see the light and come to Christ.
We participated in last year's food drop, and it was quite an awesome experience. We got our whole family involved.
I mean, I didn't really know what to expect, but it was actually really inspiring meeting these people and getting the opportunity to kind of serve and kind of get out of your element a little bit.
We met a few different women that we delivered food to, and they were really receptive to us. We got to come into their homes and pray with them and just meet people that we would never get to meet.
The thing that encouraged me was that as people received these food boxes, there was the physical need for the food, but we literally saw people's spirits lifted.
I'll never forget having my kids gather around these folks that we were delivering food to and literally praying for their family, praying for God's blessing and God's provision. And I think it was a great experience for my kids to have.
And after we had delivered the box and taken some time to pray for this woman who was a single mom, she asked then if she could pray for us. And so here we were ministering to her, and she was ministering back to us. We were floored.
I just remember one lady, she had just lost her job, and it looked like she was going to lose her house. And she had two young daughters, and she just didn't know how she didn't have enough money to buy them food. So she wept at the door, and we prayed with her.
Last year, we became aware of the fact that there was a whole apartment complex that needed about 200 boxes delivered. So we all met up at the apartment and delegated groups to head off to each different floor and got the boxes up the elevator. It was quite the feat, but we had quite the team and had a lot of fun delivering to all the different residents at that apartment.
We thought about those people frequently throughout the rest of the year, and just, you know, we think about them and we pray for them now. And just hearing their stories, and I don't know, you think you know what to expect, and then you meet these people and, you know.
I'd love to be a part of something that's bigger than what I can imagine. It's being part of something that is good for the community, being part of something that's unifying.
Being able to just see all of these people come out to deliver food to families in need, it's just an awesome experience.
I think it really says that, you know, the community is kind of tight-knit, even as large as it is, that we can come together this way. It made me feel a lot more like we're doing the Lord's work, you know, we're being His hands and feet.
Sisters, I have good news today. Religion is at an end in Lansing. Greetings, everyone. My name is Jerry Jennings, and I'm the Church of Greater Lansing Logistics Coordinator. Now, for the next few minutes, if you'll bear with me, I have some information to share with you regarding how to pick up your food boxes, where to have the food boxes delivered, what to say to the food box recipients, and what to do if no one's home. So let's get started. Now, at the end of the rally, you'll be dismissed by section, starting with the back section. Then we'll be dismissed by sections going across, and there'll be 5-6 sections. All right? Initially, only drivers, and notice that I say, only drivers of the vehicles who are delivering food boxes will exit the gymnasium by section, starting with the middle section working down. We have ushers in each section that will dismiss you as appropriate. Passengers in the car, please exit the gym and meet up with your drivers in your vehicles. But how many drove today? Can I get a show of hands? Wow, okay, all right, terrific. Drivers and drivers alone, this message is specifically for you. As you were dismissed out of the back of the gymnasium, please follow the ushers to the right of the common area to retrieve your Google map. Now, by way of explanation, a Google map is simply a set of directions to the house, the apartment, the condo, or the mobile home park you're going to be delivering boxes to today. Now, please note that this year, Google Maps will be grouped by zip code to allow a choice of where you can deliver. A zip code map should be shown on the screens to help you find your desired zip code. As maps run out, you may be asked to deliver a different zip code colored map from the same color-coded area outside your desired area. Drivers, upon approaching the Google Map tables, please tell the attendant the following: what church you are from, and the total number of people, including yourself, that are in your car. Then the map attendant will give you the appropriate number of Google Maps. And it looks like right now, you're going to get 5 boxes. And hopefully you have room in your trunk, in your SUV or your van. If not, come on back. We have boxes for you. All right. On the other, the map attendant will also give each driver a piece of paper containing a suggested prayer to pray with the food box recipient. On the other side of that paper are instructions for the food box recipient to follow if they are not home, so they can pick up the box at a later date. Make sense? All right. And lastly, on the sheet of paper is the food drop volunteer hotline number at the bottom. You can call that number if you have any difficulty in finding your delivery address today. After being given your Google Maps and prayer sheet, please exit the building at the entrance you came into to meet the other passengers at your vehicle. Once in your vehicle, please follow the parking attendant's directions and or signs to the food box distribution area assigned to where you're parked. At the entrance of the food box distribution area, and I know this is a lot of information, so just bear with me, you'll be asked to pull up the curb in groups of 5 to 6 cars. Once there, please turn off your ignition, put it in park, and pop open the trunk, all without exiting your vehicle. Now, if you have an earlier model vehicle, please feel free to take the key out of your ignition, hand it to the box loader, and they will open up your trunk for you. We just ask that everyone stay in their car for safety purposes. Please follow the directions. When all 5 vehicles in your group have been loaded with boxes, the box loaders will close your trunk, indicating that you are ready to load the exit the loading area. After exiting the Holt High School parking lot, follow the directions to the Google Map to the food box delivery address. Now, passengers and drivers, upon arriving at your delivery address, tell the recipient that you are from the Church of Greater Lansing and that you have a food box for them. Offer to place that food box on their kitchen counter because of its weight. This year it's 31 pounds of food. Amen to that. Please ask them if you can pray for them. And if the opportunity prevails and presents itself, which we pray that it does, please share the gospel of Jesus Christ. Or perhaps briefly tell them of your conversion experience and how the Lord has personally changed your life. If the food box recipient is not home, please do not leave the box nor the Google Map. Instead, leave the sheet of paper containing the prayer and instructions for how the individual can pick up the food box at a later date. Note, please do not leave the prayer sheet with instructions inside their mailbox. Postal Service gets a little upset about that. Even though the family may not be home, but we encourage you to pray for the family upon your departure. Now, after praying for the family, please immediately return the Google Map to our event staff here in the northern area of the high school. Tell the box loaders that the intended food box recipient was not home. At that time, you'll be given another Google Map and prayer card. Now, dependent upon the number of delivery vehicles today, you may be asked to return here at the high school to deliver additional boxes. To know in advance, please remember to write down the food drop volunteer hotline number that's on the other side of the prayer card at the bottom. Because of you, brothers and sisters, our valuable delivery volunteers, over 2,714 families, which is equivalent to over 8,500 people, will not go hungry for the next 2 to 4 weeks. Praise God. So thank you, delivery volunteers, for answering God's call to feed His people. Because of your efforts today in helping others, spirits will be lifted, hope will be rekindled, and families fed who would not otherwise have the means. So on behalf of the Church of Greater Lansing, thank you for partnering with us to put love into action and being the hands and feet of Christ during this year's food drop. We couldn't do it without you. Our next speaker will be Pastors Scott and Erica Hayes from Oasis East Lansing Church. And just a heads up, Erica is 2 days overdue, so please give them a welcome. What's up, everybody? Hey, what an awesome, awesome day, huh? Two reminders on some housekeeping things quickly, okay? Number one, if you're a pastor, as mentioned earlier, there's going to be a photo opportunity directly following the rally right up here at the front. Remember that. And number two, remember that the ushers will dismiss you by section. So, everybody good on that? You all got that? Okay, let's go ahead and pray.
Father God, we just want to thank you so much for this opportunity, God, to come together and be unified. The body of Christ here in the greater Lansing area, God, we thank you for what you have accomplished because of that unity already and what you will continue to accomplish in the greater Lansing area. Father God, we just pray as we go out today to deliver these boxes, God, that you supernaturally provide ministry opportunities, God, that today people's bellies will not just be filled, Lord, but their hearts and their lives will be filled with your love and your relationship, God, a relationship with Jesus Christ, Father God. We just thank you for that, God. We just pray that as we go out and we're driving around, God, that you supernaturally protect all of the drivers, that you just keep everyone safe, you just bring us all back together again so we can keep doing your work here in the greater Lansing area, Father God.
And Lord, we just want to echo the prayer that so many of your unified people have prayed. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth here today, February 26th, 2011. God, that your will would be done on earth as it is in heaven. And Lord, we thank you that people would be filled, as Erica mentioned, God, in their bellies and in their spirits today. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you that we can be unified as your body. And all of God's people said,
Amen. Amen.